The task is to find such x that satisfies the following identity, or to prove that there is no solution to this equation. To have a starting point, let's assume that this identity is a correct one. So under this assumption, there should be such angles, let's name them alpha, whose sine and cosine will give us the arccos and arccos from the original identity. Also, we can notice that the original equation will turn into the basic trigonometric identities. So far, so good. Now, let's take a closer look on the sum of arccos and arccos, which in our case will be equal to the sum of sine alpha and cosine alpha. There is no direct formula to simplify this sum, but we can use a trick. Basically, we rewrite cosine alpha as sine pi divided by 2 minus alpha. And now we can use a basic formula for the sum of two sine functions. Simplifying this equation, we arrive to a single term, which can be further simplified since we know that the value for sine pi divided by 4 is square root of 2 divided by 2. It will lead us to the final form of the identity. Here, we can estimate the upper bound of this term, which will be a square root of 2. Because whatever argument of sine and cosine we take, it will not give us a value higher than 1. Thus, our sum of arccos and arccos can be written as the following, and according to our derivations, it should be less than the square root of 2. Okay, but from the definition of arccos and arccos, the sum of these two functions applied to the same argument should be equal to pi divided by 2, which, recalling that pi is approximately 3.14, will lead to the fact that this equation should be higher than the square root of 2. And here we have arrived to the contradiction, because if the original identity holds, then the sum of arccos and arccos should be less or equal to square root of 2. But it contradicts to the basic definition of the arccos and arccos, therefore the original identity is not possible.
That's impossible!
Okay, but here you can tell me, but this type of a solution is not a general one. What if we had been given not 1, but 1.5 or 2 in the original identity? Then there would have been no such a convenient contradiction that we could have used. It's a fair point, and there is a way to have a general answer in such type of a problem. For this one, we need to analyze the function, sum of the squares of arccos and arccos, and check some of its properties to see whether it can fit the required identity. Now, I encourage you to try it. So, analyze the form of the function, find its extremum, and prove that there are no such x that fit the original formulation. So, feel free to post your ideas, comments, or just emotions in the comment section below. It does help to improve the content, and it's a great support. Of course, if you like this video, please give it a thumb up, and do not hesitate to subscribe to the channel, allowing all notifications not to miss new videos about math and neuroscience. And for now, I hope to see you soon.